As you saw earlier in the course, protocol stacks are made of layers, where each layer depends on abstractions provided by the layer below. Let's take another look up and down that stack to see where we are. As a developer, you're usually working at one particular layer of abstraction at a time. But it's important to know about the lower layers, because the way they work affects the way they can fail and what strange things can happen to your application. Web applications rely on HTTP to send requests about resources and get responses. You use libraries like Flask or Requests to build HTTP applications. Some ideas that are visible at the HTTP layer include URLs for resources and methods, cookies, HTTP verbs. Any misbehavior of lower layers is mostly visible at the HTTP layer as errors and high latency, requests that fail or that take unreasonably long to complete. HTTP is implemented in browsers and in web servers, as well as in proxies and firewalls and some other tools like that. That code uses TCP, but the code that says, in order to send an HTTP request, connect to the server on port 80 and transmit the following bytes, is part of the web browser, and the corresponding code for understanding HTTP requests and sending responses is part of the web server. Web apps don't need to reinvent that, they just make use of the features the browser and server already implement. But the browser up here doesn't tell your Wi-Fi or Ethernet adapter down here exactly what to transmit to your router. The browser makes use of the TCP networking services that your operating system provides. Connecting to a server on a port and having a reliable stream of bytes between that client and server is a feature provided by your OS's TCP implementation. Whether you're on Mac or Windows or Linux or something else, modern OS's provide TCP built in. User programs such as browsers just have to use them. Within the OS's networking code, TCP, in turn, relies on the lower-level protocol IP to deliver packets between hosts and to pass them through the intermediate hops, the routers. An IP, in turn, relies on hardware like Wi-Fi or Ethernet and device drivers to physically shift data between devices on the same physical network. Now, not all network applications use TCP. Ping uses ICMP. DNS primarily uses UDP, as do a number of other things like the network time protocol that keeps your time and date in sync. But all of these underlying protocols are provided by the operating system. We'll see a lot more about these in this lesson. One more thing. Be careful what layer you're talking about. There are a lot of terms in common between them. For example, a Wi-Fi connection, or associating with a particular Wi-Fi access point, has nothing particularly to do with a TCP connection, also known as a session. And a TCP session has nothing particularly to do with a web user session, identified by, for instance, session cookies on a logged-in user.